Today I'm back out on the Richardson farm and we're harvesting some wheat, and I thought that would be a great opportunity to talk about two of the most interesting things I've learned during my time here, which are crop rotation and zero till. Crop rotation means that this wheat won't be wheat next year. It will likely be canola. Crop rotations follow a typical four-year rotation between oilseed to cereal to pulse back to cereal. And the rotation takes place because different plants leave a different amount of residue, residue being organic matter or plant leftovers. This is residue. And a field with less residue will dry quicker, and that allows for seeding to take place earlier in the spring.
Residue can also be beneficial. For example, the residue from a crop of lentils is full of nitrogen, which is absorbed into the soil, benefiting future crops.
Zero-till is pretty self-explanatory, I hope. Done are the days of Old MacDonald with a plow and a horse going across fields. Tilling breaks the surface of the soil, exposing the moisture locked beneath to the hot sun. That dries out the soil, which is, you know, not good for growing plants that need moisture.
Think of zero-till like these leftover lentils. With the lid on, moisture is safely trapped inside. But take the lid off and introduce a warm prairie wind, and you quickly lose moisture along with a bit of your soil.
Personally, I find crop rotation and zero-till incredibly interesting because they're both simple practices that significantly increase sustainability and production.
Oh yeah, and because I love numbers, in 2015, Saskatchewan contributed 85% of Canada's total durum production. This year, just like I said with the canola last time, we're gonna have to wait and see.